Hey, Angel here from mynexttablet.com. Today with a couple of tips and tricks for the Samsung Galaxy Tab A7. Let's get started. All right, let's get to the tips and tricks for the Samsung Galaxy Tab A7. First of all, if you have used the Samsung device before, then you probably will know everything I will tell you in this video already. But if you're new to Android and especially new to a Samsung tablet, then you will probably learn a couple of things. The first thing I want to teach you is how to use the split screen view. For that, you simply hit on this multitasking button and then you tip on the icon and then you select open in split screen view. And then you can open another app like YouTube. This is YouTube, this is Google Chrome, and then you can use two apps at the same time. If you press here, you can switch the two apps. And that's how it works. Pretty nice multitasking. There's another multitasking thing you can do. You can hit again this multitasking button here, and then you can hit it and say open in pop-up view. That opens YouTube in this case in a free floating window where you can adjust the window size. And yeah, that's quite useful. It's basically, you know, a little bit like on a desktop system. So you can open two apps like this, for instance. And another thing that's built in that's very interesting is this transparency feature. You can adjust the transparency of an app. Now with YouTube, it doesn't make that much sense, but for instance, you could watch a lecture on YouTube or something and then have the Notes app on top of it and adjust the transparency of the Notes app so that you can take notes while watching a lecture in full screen view. That can be quite useful. I'm sure you're familiar with these three typical Android buttons at home, back, and the multi-app view. Now you can change them to gestures, which you might be familiar with from your phone. To do that, you just go to the settings, then you go to display, then you go to navigation bar, and you can activate swipe gestures. Then you can use the gestures to navigate the operating system like I just did here. Now on my lock screen here, I have something very interesting. It says contact mynexttablet.com. So if somebody finds it, hopefully say contact mynexttablet.com. They get my information from the website and then hopefully send me an email or call me. Now to have a message on your lock screen, you go to settings, then you go to lock screen and then to contact information. And then you can put your phone number, your email address or your website or something. And then hopefully if you lose your tablet, somebody will contact you, hopefully, and you will get it back. Usually you always have to type in a PIN or so if you want to unlock your tablet, but there's facial recognition built into this tablet. I will quickly demonstrate it. It works very well. Here my face got recognized. To activate it, you either do it when setting it up first. But if you didn't do it when setting it up first, you go to the settings, then you go to biometrics and security, and then you go to face recognition. Then you've got to enter your PIN, and then you can activate face unlock and, you know, put in your face basically. And you can also turn on brighten screen when it's dark. So when it's dark, the facial recognition doesn't work as amazingly because it only uses the webcam. It's not super secure. But yeah, you can activate brighten screen and then the screen gets brighter. So there's a little bit of light on your face and then hopefully it can recognize you. It doesn't work as amazingly as it does in good light, but yeah, it works. Now what works very well with facial recognition is double tap to wake. So I can double tap on the screen, it gets activated, my face gets recognized and I basically can start to work immediately. You have to turn that on in the settings first. For that, you go to the settings, then you go to advanced features and then to motion and gestures, and then you can turn on double tap to wake. I think it's a very useful feature. One of the most common questions I get asked is how to take a screenshot with the Galaxy Tab A7. That's very simple. You hit the power button and the volume rocker. Not too long, but a little bit, maybe a second or so, and then it takes a screenshot. If you want, you can even annotate it. Now, obviously, there is no active pen support here, but you can use your finger or a pen for capacitive screens. It doesn't work amazingly, but if you want to annotate a screenshot, circle something or so, you can do that and just save it as a JPEG or so. One thing I like about the search of the app overview in OneUI is that it searches not only the apps, but also Spotify, Netflix, and so on. I already pre-searched Star Trek, so let's just search for Star Trek, and it searches for apps, for contacts, and also the Galaxy App Store, even the Google App Store and Spotify here. Usually it should show Netflix as well. I don't know why it's not showing Netflix at the moment, but yeah, it can search other things too. So if you want to search Spotify fast or for an app very fast, just type it in the standard search and then it searches those places as well. Now the Galaxy Tab A7 has a pretty good battery life, but if you're on your last 10 or 20%, then you might want to turn on the energy saving mode. You can do that either via the quick settings menu by pressing this button, or you go to the settings and then you go to device care, battery, and then to power mode. Standard is optimized. I would just leave it most of the time. You can put it to medium power saving or to maximum power saving, and then it turns out quite a heavy energy saving mode. It limits the CPU speed to 70%, so it gets slower, and it adjusts the brightness. So let's apply that, and then you will see that it switches the interface a bit. It lowers the brightness, limits the CPU speed, and it's restricting background data. That means that apps in the background don't get refreshed as often as they usually do. It also turns on the dark mode. So there we go. That's the interface from the energy saving mode. You can open a couple of Samsung apps. You can add a couple of Google apps like YouTube, Chrome, and so on, even Samsung Notes. But you can notice that there are no games when using the maximum power saving mode. Now, I'm turning off the power saving mode right now and you've seen the dark mode. You don't have to use the power saving mode to use a dark mode. You can also turn it on manually. And I don't think with an LCD screen it actually saves that much power, but it can certainly be nice for your eyes. To activate the dark mode, you go to the quick settings, swipe over, and turn on dark mode here. Works very well. It also turns on the dark mode in Google Chrome, like I have here. My website doesn't have a dark mode, but Chrome does. And also on YouTube, for instance, and of course in all Samsung apps, you can see here, the dark mode is turned on already. Now, if you want to go easy on your eyes or want to get some sleep, you can also turn on a blue light filter. Apparently, that makes you go to sleep easier if not a blue light is shining at you. So yeah, you just turn it on via the quick settings menu. Now, if you have kids, you maybe don't want them to browse your emails, to watch your YouTube videos, and to freely surf the internet. If you have very young kids, you can give them the tablet and activate the Samsung Kids mode. That's only something for very small, very young kids, I would say. It's basically a very simple interface for kids to play around with, to draw something or so. Like here, very simple apps and so on. I don't think if your kid is going to school, the Kids mode will be useful because maybe then they want to do some research or whatever. But for very young kids, maybe it's useful. Now, I don't have kids myself, so it's always a bit hard for me to judge how useful these kids mode really are. But, you know, if you have young kids, just check it out. If you want to get some serious work done with your tablet, you can of course use Microsoft Office, which is pre-installed, and then you can use your on-screen keyboard to write something. But a better way is to just use a standard desktop keyboard. I've got a Logitech K780 here, which is a standard Bluetooth keyboard that you can connect to the Samsung Galaxy Tab A7, and it works very well. But it's even better if you also use a mouse. This is a Logitech M705, I believe. It doesn't really matter which keyboard or mouse you use, you can connect almost every mouse and keyboard. I'm connecting the mouse with this dongle, and I'm also using a USB-C to USB-A adapter for that. So let me quickly do that, and then you will see that you can use, here, the mouse is recognized. You can use the Galaxy Tab A with the standard desktop mouse and with the standard keyboard. This is a quick test and it works very well. It does indeed. So you can get some really nice work done here in Microsoft Word. You can of course also open it in a pop-up view. So you almost have a desktop experience. Of course, not really, but almost you can have a desktop experience here. That's quite nice, I think. So let me also open Chrome in a pop-up view. and put it over here. Then let's go back to Word and put it here. So you see me here using two apps at the same time with a desktop keyboard and a mouse. I think that's quite useful. All right, these have been a couple of tips and tricks for the Samsung Galaxy Tab A7. If you have any questions, write them down below. And if you discovered a setting or something that's super interesting that I haven't mentioned, then write us in the comments as well. I'm sure everybody who watches this video will be interested in further tips and tricks. I'm Andrew from MyNextTablet.com. Thanks for watching and see you next time.